Hello there, and welcome to this two-part video series that will explain the format of the events being ran on the IDFRS Motorsports Network. The first part of this video will elaborate on the AI Cup Racing Series. This will entail how the series are ran, how to participate, and some general questions one may have. For those who are not interested in listening to an AI voice narrating such things, I do apologize in advance, as this was the quickest method with company over during the recording session. Well, without further ado, let's get into the meat and potatoes of this first parter. With the recent changes taking place in the IDFRS Motorsports Network, we are looking for methods to get drivers into these series as our events are more long-term than short-term. First up is the AI Cup Lights. This series is one of two entry points to get into AI Cup. Whether this is related to the Xfinity series or ARCA, AI Cup Lights is like the name states, a lighter version of AI Cup. Lights runs 12 races in a season and follows the same points format as AI Cup. The main difference is the amount of points distributed from leading a lap and leading the most laps. After the first six races are finished, the top 10 drivers in the standings will advance to compete for the championship title, while the remaining entries will undergo a points reset. If there are multiple drivers tied, they can retain their points until the tie is broken. After, the drivers will be docked a certain amount of points to prevent a catch-up with the top 10, but enough to stay ahead of everyone else below them. Once a season of lights is wrapped up, the top three drivers will be eligible for advancing to the CUP series and participate in the IROC. If a lights driver refuses to advance to the CUP series, they can remain in lights and participate in other events once registration opens. In the event of a tie in the top three, then we make an exception of allowing those drivers to advance into the CUP series. So, keeping it really short, top three advance, multiple ties means more drivers can get in. Sounds like a good trade-off, I would like to think. Now for a recent question I've been noticing, what about late entries? Once signups have closed after a certain date or have filled up, that's it. Latecomers will have a disadvantage as races are recorded weeks in advance and won't be able to get into the CUP series. The good news is, the IDFRS Motorsports Network has created another series named ACS, a shorthand for the Apprentice CUP series. ACS is shorter than lights, running 7 races. These races take place on short paved tracks and dirt ovals. Due to the size of certain tracks, the roster is smaller, and entries are limited to one driver. If you're someone who is in lights and wants another chance at getting into the CUP series, ACS is for you. However, the drawback in ACS is only the champion will be allowed to move into the CUP series and gain a spot into IROC. And don't worry, this IROC talk I keep mentioning will be explained in part 2. And now, the main event of the IDFRS Motorsports Network, the AI Cup Series. The CUP Series is where drivers from lights, ACS, and longtime entrants compete for a chance at glory, and a slight bonus to their driver ratings. First, we'll discuss the season, divisions, and whatever else comes to mind. It should be noted, the CUP Series has no sign-up form, as the field caps at 42 entries. A season in CUP will last 24 instead of the current 20 race schedule. Each race has a stage format, and some races will have more stages based on how far into the season it takes place. Unlike NASCAR, all drivers will be awarded points based on where they finish. In the CUP Series, there are three divisions competing: the IDFRS, Intermediate, and Rookie. Drivers coming in from lights and ACS will be placed into the Rookie division. The exception being entrants who were from the days of our online league races will be placed in the IDFRS division. Some may see this as unfair, but there is a reason for that. Rookie drivers have a max rating of 80, but will have a randomized minimum driver rating from 0 to 80. It should be noted, all three divisions have a car rating of 80 and a pit crew rating of 99. At the end of a season, rookies that finish in the top three will be promoted to intermediate. In the intermediate division, rookie drivers will gain a max driver rating of 85 and retain their previous ratings from when they were in rookies. At the end of the season, only two intermediates will be promoted to the elite division, the IDFRS. And now, the IDFRS division. Originally, this division was a place where old members from the Forza Motorsport and Gran Turismo online leagues could continue their rivalries in NR 2003, has now become the division where the intermediates can compete against the greats for the championship title. IDFR's members start with a max driver rating of 90. At the end of a season, returning champions gain a stat increase that is randomly placed into a max driver rating. Champions are eligible for a max driver rating of 95. As a bonus, IDFRS champions are entered into the IROC series. In the event the Cup Series has more than 42 entries, a special race will be held to give drivers down in the point standings a shot at getting into the main race. As for how many can get in, we'll determine the amount of additional drivers. As for the reason certain drivers receive a jump into the IDFRS division instead of starting out in rookies, is based on the driver's name from our online league days. Keep in mind, this is 7 years worth of online league races, and many names have come and gone since then. Drivers in the Cup Series can cancel or make changes to their contract at the end of a season. Additionally, Cup drivers who are struggling can return back to Lights and ACS. On the flip side, they're not allowed to re-enter Cup for one season. No one likes bushwhackers. And lastly, the Cup Series has a team point system separate from everything else. Teams have a max of 3 drivers and all run the same manufacturer. Teams can swap out drivers before the start of a season if they so wish. That wraps up the first video. For additional questions, please reach out to our Discord or comment below. Video 2 will go into detail about other IDFRS events and the aforementioned IROC series. Take care and see you soon.